Lawyer Joel Viado vows to fight corruption and boost digital transformation as he takes over the helm of the Philippine Immigration Bureau. Viado also fully supports the president's push for a new immigration law to replace the 84-year-old Philippine Immigration Act, which he described as outdated and an obstacle to modernization efforts. He is looking to streamline procedures, remove redundancies, and improve cooperation with the Justice Department. Prior to his appointment as the agency's new commissioner, Viado was appointed officer in charge of the agency following the dismissal of former Commissioner Norman Tansingco, who was removed after disgraced Mayor Alice Cuo escaped the country. Viado was also a lawyer representing several multinational corporations in construction operations across Asia, the United States, and Europe. He also served in the presidential management staff under then-President Joseph Estrada. The Philippine Ports Authority has submitted a list of consignees who have yet to release their rice shipments at Manila ports to the Department of Agriculture. This is part of ongoing efforts to ensure efficient management of rice shipments and improve overall ports operations after the agency discovered that several rice importers are deliberately holding their shipments at terminals waiting for prices to go up. PPA data show a total of 819 20 equivalent foot units currently at Manila South Harbor and Manila International Container Terminal, with 40 TEUs exceeding 30 days at MICT. The list also includes an inventory of pork, chicken, and onion shipments. The PPA has committed to increased monitoring of these inventories ahead of the Christmas season, when demand for such goods is expected to rise. Transport Secretary Jimmy Bautista says Philippine aviation is on the cusp of major transformation and poised to become a leading regional player. This amid the record aircraft order by low-cost carrier Cebu Pacific and the ongoing rehabilitation of the country's main gateway. Jackie Pascual tells us more.
Budget carrier Cebu Pacific has signed a landmark aircraft purchase agreement with Airbus and Pratt & Whitney. This is for up to 152 narrow-body aircraft valued at $24 billion or 1.4 trillion pesos. The first delivery from this deal is expected in 2029, but Cebu Pacific still has 22 aircraft expected to be delivered in the next 2 years from previous orders.
These agreements with Airbus and Pratt & Whitney are far more than commercial transactions. They represent a strategic investment in our future, a future defined by modernization, efficiency, expansion, and an enhanced travel experience for our passengers.
Officials hailed the deal, which is the largest in Philippine aviation history, highlighting the growth of the region, not just in aviation, but in the overall economy.
We are confident that this additional A320 will contribute strongly to your next phase of expansion as one of Asia-Pacific's leading low-cost airline.
The latest order demonstrates the growing opportunities for aviation in the Philippines and the larger Asia-Pacific region.
The airline is confident it can utilize the arrival of more planes in the coming years with the construction of the Bulacan Airport and the rehabilitation of Manila's Ninoy Aquino International Airport. The new operator of NAIA has recently implemented rate increases for landing and takeoff fees, as well as aircraft parking fee. Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista says this will somehow have an impact on airfares.
If it will increase, it should not be a huge increase, no? Because the airlines, no, can absorb part of it, no? Part of it can be passed on to the passengers, no?
Fares will have to be adjusted to account for these costs, no? But I think we have to take a wait and see, muna. Let's see what happens muna sa airport. Tingnan natin kung anong improvements ipapasok.
At the Aviation Summit organized by the European Chamber of Commerce of the Philippines and the Asian Business Aviation Association, Senator Grace Po urged Bautista to review the NAIA rate hikes. Bautista defended the rate increases, saying these are needed to modernize the country's main gateway.
Of course, you get what you pay for. But perhaps this could be reviewed as the increase in takeoff fees for both international and domestic carriers could possibly affect the airline's viability to operate flights to the Philippines.
Yung increase niya is medyo mataas siya. It's more than, I think it's almost double, no? Alam niyo, the rates, the last increase was in year 2000. But this is for the concessionaire to be able to also recover their investments, no? And for them to spend money for the modernization of the airport.
Other aviation officials in the summit are eager for the modernization of NAIA and on the planned improvements of Philippine airports, saying these upgrades are a must as aviation plays a critical role in the country's economic story. Jackie Pascual, ABS-CBN News.
Phil Health is set to implement another increase in its all case rates by November of this year. The state insurer announced the rates will go up by as much as 50% this year. Now, for context, all case rates refer to Phil Health's system for paying inpatient care based on specific cases. And by December, Phil Health will also cover dental services, including prophylaxis, oral checkups, and fluoridization. The agency's rule on the single period of confinement has also been lifted as of October 1st. This rule previously limited benefits for the same illness within a 90-day period to single claims. From health to education, Yale students may be speaking in Tagalog as early as fall 2025. This following Harvard University's historic move to hire Lady Eileen Orsal to offer their first Tagalog language course last year, and Yale is about to do just that. The Council on Southeast Asia Studies at Yale University has officially advertised for a Filipino instructor position with courses set to begin in the fall of 2025. The creation of a Tagalog program comes after members of a Filipino student organization called Kasama expressed their frustrations over the lack of such course. More than 380 students and faculty members signed Kasama's petition to include Tagalog in the school's international language courses. Now, the search is on for a full-time Tagalog instructor. And in case you missed it, the International Monetary Fund lowers its growth forecast for the Philippines this year. Officials of the multilateral lender now see the Philippine economy expanding by just 5.8% in 2024. That's down from its initial forecast of 6%. That was back in July. It's also below the government's target range of 6 to 7%. Now, similarly, the IMF cut its 2025 forecast for the country at 6.1% from the previous 6.2% for next year. Among the lender's recommendations to spur growth would be more rate cuts by the central bank and a careful communication of those policy settings to help manage economic uncertainty.
Inflation already coming down to within the target band, also inflation expectations coming down, and the opening of a small negative output gap. We do think that a gradual continued reduction in the policy rate is appropriate.
The data-dependent approach is very important. So, yes, there is loosening, but caution is still necessary in the coming months because of an uncertain environment.